Hey everybody, this is John for Arena Nexus MTG, coming at you with another historic brawl video. This time we're going away a little bit from the budget variety and going with one of the three decks that I've had for quite some time before I even started making brawl content, and that is Zakama Primal Calamity. Before we get into that, if you do like explore and historic brawl content, please consider subscribing to the channel, giving us a thumbs up, and leaving a constructive comment down below. And we're going to be going to a more steady upload schedule. Every Monday, we're going to be doing Explore content for whatever deck we're working on this month. This month, that will mostly be Karuga Fires with an Enigmatic Incarnation. And then every other Thursday, we'll be releasing a Historic Brawl video. That way, you know, you're going to have each Monday, you're going to have an Explore video. Every other Thursday, you're going to have a Brawl video. Now, one thing I will say about Zakama is this is not the most competitive Brawl deck. One of the downsides, or upsides, and however you will look at it with Brawl, is you tend to get paired against like-powered commanders. Now, they shuffle them into different tiers, but Zakama is a very powerful commander, so a lot of times you get paired up against the very powerful things. You get paired up against Atraxes, and, you know, sometimes you get paired up against the 5-mana all-stars like Niv-Mizzet or Asika. So this is generally not going to be the most competitive of Brawl decks. But what it is a very strong, very efficient tribal deck that plays a lot of big, beefy boys. You know, obviously, you have Zakama, who is a Swiss Army knife. If it stays on the battlefield, especially against anything that's not hard control, generally this dinosaur is going to dominate, especially if you have 7, 8, 9 lands. You can blow up, you know, couple of your opponent's creatures, an artifact, come down, gain some life, etc. It's very powerful. The rest of the deck, you know, you get to play Bing Dumb Idiots like Galta, Tarrasque, Jusoth here. Whenever it deals combat damage, reveal that many, put any number of dinosaurs on the battlefield. Waking Sun's Avatar, basically a Wrath for Dinos only. Zatulpa, just big dumb beatdown. Belligerent Brontodon, your creature's assigned to combat. Other dinosaurs get pumped, plus you get to make dudes. Carnage Tyrant, Uncounterable Monster. Burning Sun's Avatar, which really likes to be camera hog this particular set of videos. Comes down, shoots a creature. Atali, this is very powerful. Now, there are a couple of dinosaurs that have been printed since then, or powerful big dumb idiots, so this deck has not been updated. One card you might want to consider is the other copy of Atali, just because it's also a broken dumb idiot. And then, you know, there were some other accelerant examples, like the new, there's a new 1-mana halfling that allows you to, comes into play, taps for a colorless or taps for any color. You can only use it to cast legendary spells. Those spells can't be countered. Kind of helps some of the problems this deck has, which can be sometimes your opponent with a bunch of counter spells. Yeah, but I digress. There are other options, obviously, you can play with the deck, so this deck is a little bit dated, but it's still a lot of fun. You have a lot of early acceleration, Lana War Elves, Kajini Callers, a lot of just different ways to reduce what your opponent's casting costs for all your dinos are, along with your artifact accelerants. You have your Herald's Horn, Herald's Banner, Vanquisher's Banner, all ways to kind of recoup cards. And then you have some decent mid-range dinos, as well as other cost reducers like Goreclaw, Knight of the Stampede, Mitigation's Path, and yeah, just solid all around, pound-for-pound creatures. Much like Anaya, good stuff deck with it all being dino-based. Like I said, I'm sure there are some updates that this deck could endure, but it's mainly cost reducers, cost accelerators, big dumb dinos. Hope that's good enough. Some matches that is, some matches it isn't, but this deck's more about trying to have some fun and cast some big monsters than necessarily casting the best cards of a tricolor deck. But that's it. Let's get into some matches and see how we do in today's Historic Brawl video. All right, we're here with our first one with Zakama. It feels a little slew. So Seeing isn't a ton better, but we'll try it. I put back more creatures. Those creatures damage this turn. I'm just put back the Crusher for this turn. Sorry, right. In Brawl, you get a free mulligan. Thoughtseize. I'm guessing they'll take Cultivate here. Yeah, I should play Fatal Passage first. The downside with playing as a comma, even though it's a lower powered, at least when you're playing a tribal variant of it, is a lower powered brawl commander, you do get paired into a lot of the more higher power, like Atraxa Grand Unifier, Atraxa, the one that persists, etc. So. Meant to get a red source. Apparently I grabbed planes. Good job. Yep, despite the cost being reduced in my hand, these are not inquisitionable targets, so. It's going to be kind of hard to beat. Thank you. Good chance that just gets hit by an ECD. I think we can safely give up on this one. All right, up against Zero and Ojutai. Normal Gargan's control. One in your hand, and turn those as long as into the battlefield this turn. Turn one of the dragons to its owner's hand. I think this hand just doesn't do enough. Hands. Alright. Cost reducer go. Got a lot of playing against Jeskai Bull control. One of the cards this deck might be able to benefit with is the new legendary druid thing from a legendary halfling, since a good bit of its will actually cast a Divine Detail on that. Okay. Something like, yep, Thundering Bull here. No sweepers yet. Thank you. Good chance they'll just cast a sweeper here. Nope, nothing. Okay, presume you have a counter to this, but if you don't, you're in a lot of trouble. Four. Mm-hmm. cannot go for it otherwise. We're basically dead this turn. Very, very good chance they have a counter spell in their hand. Nope, just a way to gain life. That's annoying. I think that's enough. Alright, this verse is fixed one of the has fixed one of the work. You put a human card attack and instructable first one more. Okay. So it is actually possible to play one of that in the format. Good to know. Although it's obviously nowhere near as powerful as Unfixed Winota, because Unfixed Winota says you get a trigger for each non whatchamacallit that you play. Raging Regisaur. Four, five, six. If we draw a land. That's just kind of mean. It's a rather nasty card. Alright, and that's game. Alright, we'll try one more game, hoping for a little bit more of a actual game? Question mark? And there's zombies. Da 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 da. Snarl? I guess we'll do on. Neither player is doing anything. Seems good for us. Good chance it dies. This die too. Yep. Excuse me? Alrighty then. Okay. Alright, we'll give it one last run, and if that don't work, we'll just call it a day. Thank you. gets to ramp here by discarding the planes, getting it back. Draw land off this. We do. You have swords on top of everything else? Of course you do. Three, four, five, six, seven, eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Thank you. All right. Nice to finally end up on a winning note here.